Welcome to the Explainer. You ever see the price of a product overseas and wonder how it ends up with its final price tag here? Today, we're going to break down exactly that, using a car as our case study. We'll look at how things like global prices, exchange rates, and, yeah, taxes can give us some pretty surprising results.
Okay, let's just dive right in. You might think it's a simple conversion, but as you're about to see, the journey from a dollar price tag in one country to a shekel price tag here, well, it involves a few really crucial steps. We're going to walk through it with a real-world example to see exactly how it all works. First things first, we need a starting point, right? And it all begins with two key pieces of info: what the car costs in its original currency, in this case, US dollars, and, of course, the current exchange rate.
So at its heart, the basic math is actually super simple. The local price, which we'll call P, is just the world price, we'll call that P star, multiplied by the exchange rate, or E. This little formula is basically the foundation for figuring out the price of almost any imported good.
So for our example, let's plug in some numbers. The car we're looking at costs a nice even $12,000 on the world market. And to keep things simple, we'll say the exchange rate is a flat 6 shekels to the dollar. So you just do the quick math, that's $12,000 times 6, and you get your base local price for the car, 72,000 shekels. Now remember that number? That's our starting line, you know, before anything else comes into the picture.
Okay, so we have our number, but what does that actually look like from an economic point of view? I mean, how would an economist actually draw this on a classic supply and demand graph?
This is actually pretty cool. On a standard graph, you know, with price going up and down and quantity going side to side, the supply for this car is just a perfectly flat, horizontal line. It sits right at that 72,000 shekel mark. And what that means is, at this price, the market can basically get its hands on as many cars as people want to buy. The supply is, for our purposes, unlimited.
So let's make this real for a second. Let's imagine that at this 72,000 shekel price, there's enough demand for people to go out and buy 800 of these cars. So how much money are we talking about in total? What's the whole market worth?
To figure that out, the math is again super straightforward. You just take the price of one car, that's our 72,000 shekels, and you multiply it by the number of cars that got sold, in this case, 800.
And whoa, that number really shows you the scale we're talking about. The total expenditure comes out to a whopping 57,600,000 shekels. That's the total value of all 800 of those cars sold in the local market.
All right, but that was the easy part. That was the simple scenario. Let's move on and see what happens when the government decides to step in and throw a little wrench into our calculation, a tariff.
Okay, now things get really interesting because two things happen at the exact same time. First, the government slaps a 20% tariff on these cars. And second, at the same moment, the car's price on the world market actually goes up to $14,000. So what do you think happens to the final price? Does it go up? Down?
Now, here's the crucial detail, the real twist in our example. This 20% tariff isn't just added on top at the end. The way it's applied here is that it directly messes with the currency conversion. Think of it like this. For every dollar the importer exchanges to buy the car, they lose 20% of its value to the tariff. So their effective exchange rate plummets from 6 shekels per dollar all the way down to just 4.8.
So let's recap. We have a higher world price for the car, but because of that tariff, we have a lower effective exchange rate. So let's crunch these new numbers and see what actually happens to that final price tag on the lot.
So here are our new inputs for the same simple formula. We take that new world price, $14,000, and we multiply it by our new tariff-adjusted effective exchange rate of 4.8. And would you look at that? The new local price is 67,200 shekels. Now, think about that for a second. Even though the car itself got more expensive in dollars, the final price you pay here has actually dropped. Kind of wild, right? So, what does this mean for our graph? Well, it means that whole flat supply line literally gets pulled downward. It shifts from the old price of 72,000 down to the new, lower price of 67,200. The car is now actually cheaper for people to buy in the local market. So here it is, the key takeaway, all laid out side by side. You can see so clearly how powerful that change in the effective exchange rate was. It was so strong that it completely wiped out the $2,000 increase in the car's dollar price, and then some, leading to an overall price decrease. This whole case study just shows how incredibly connected everything is.
global prices, exchange rates, government policies, all of it. And it kind of leaves us with a final thought, right? A tariff is one kind of twist. But what other real-world events, I'm talking about things like supply chain problems or new trade deals, what else could suddenly change the price of everything you import every single day?